Hello and welcome to 9design 3D. Today we will make a fantasy clothes for our game characters. For the using this in a game or game engines, I think you have to a bit optimize and you have to bake your textures. I will only show this in modeling type in here without saving or modeling your clothes. I will give you link in description for this character model. If you want to learn how to make character modeling, you can go from the top right card. I made a video tutorial for this. And now let's go to the tutorial. I imported my FBX character in here. For import your character, go File, Import and choose an FBX. When you choose your model, it will become in your scene. We will use this character's polygons for making our clothes. As you see, in Tap to Edit mode, our model will look like that. In Tap to Edit mode, you can choose some faces from your character's body. And as you see, with the Control and Numpad Plus, you can choose other faces, and with the holding shift, choose other and back faces for your character. Press Shift D, duplicate your mesh, and after that press P and selection, separate it. Now in Tap to Edit mode, especially go to wireframe, that's shortcut Z, and you can delete half of it. After that, in the object mode, you can add your mirror modifier in here. Don't forget to check clipping. Now, as you see, you can choose all of it with A and Alt S to scale it. With the numpad 1, you can go to front view and move your vertices. And if you want to extrude some back to faces, you can E to extrude edge line and merge some vertices at the center. I will give a smooth shape to this. I'm not making any extra thing in here. You can move your vertices with G. If you want to make some shoulder parts of it, you can E to extrude your vertices, and with the numpad 3 is the side view, you can E to extrude it and add extra loop cuts with the Control R, moving your vertices in Z axis. And for the back looking, you can press Control and numpad 1. And G to move your vertices because our mirror modifier's clipping is open. You can give a shape, choose some vertices in here and right click smooth your vertices. It will smooth it and it will make it easy. Now in object mode, we will add a subdivision surface modifier to this. And you can move some glitchy parts in here with your vertices, and don't forget to scale it again with the Alt S. For our blouse will be look like that. If you want, for the shoulder amulets, you can choose some edge lines and E to extrude for the shoulder tops. And you can scale your edge lines in Y axis. It will look like that. And move your vertices, give a round shape. For the back, you can choose some vertices and E to extrude them. We will connect it our blouse and the back part of it. And choose 4 vertices and have to fill. For the making shield necklace, you can choose again some faces. We will use all the same method in here. Choose your faces with Alt and Shift, and after that, Shift D to duplicate. Press P and separate it. And now, as you see, there is a triangle in here. Before this, go to Z to wireframe and choose half of it and delete your vertices. We will add a mirror modifier and check your clipping in object mode. There is some triangle in here. You can delete the vertices from here. Choose your vertices and E to extrude. After that, choose your 4 vertices and F to fill. Continue to extrude for connect your parts. If you want, if it's not give a good shape for you, you can add extra loop cuts with Ctrl R. But don't forget to choose your vertices and right click smooth your vertices. Which shape you want, which type you want, you can use this. Or you can take some reference from the Google. I I made this type of shape, a smooth shape. For the middle vertex, I will delete it. And now, for the middle of it, you can E to extrude your vertices to the up. Choose your four vertex and F to fill again. We will make same method for the closet. Merge these two vertices at center. Choose your four vertex again F to fill and make same thing. Our necklace will look like that. If you want your neck parts as an amulet, you can choose your edge lines and E to extrude and scale in Y axis. I will make it this type of shape. And I will delete these vertices because I want to make it separately. And add extra loop cuts for giving your round shape. Let's make our pants. For this, we will choose some faces with the Alt and Shift. And after that, as the same method, you can choose these button faces, Shift D to duplicate and P selection. Choose your pants and Alt S to scale. Is it wireframe? We will make it for modeling easy. Choose half of it and delete them. In tap to object mode again and add your mirror modifier, check your clipping. Now you can give your shape how you want. Again the same method, Alt S to scale. And add some subdivision surface modifier to this. For the back parts, you can move your vertices and tie them up in here. For the belt, if you want, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale these top faces and add extra loop cuts. Which shape you want, you can make it. For the bottom part of your pants, you can make same thing. E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. And after that, add extra loop cuts for giving sharp edges. And don't forget to shade smooth. Let's make our characters high heel boots. For this, as the same method, in Z to wireframe, we will choose some faces for two legs. And you can again shift it to duplicate P selection. Now you can Alt S your boot parts. For the bottom edge line, you can choose this and E to extrude down. With numpad 3 for the side view, I will E to extrude it and I will add extra loop cuts in here. And you can move it and give a shape of your character's foot. If you want, you can delete your character's foot and make only boots. I am tidying up, E to extrude down again. And you can scale it. For the heels part, you can choose some faces and E to extrude down. And add extra loop cut for the bottom. Let's make a good topology for under our boots. Choose these four vertices and across it, F to fill. Choose side vertices and continue to press F. Make same thing for the other side. Continue to press F. For the upside of your boots, you can choose some vertices and E to extrude up. You can add extra loop cuts and give a shape how you want. For the pants, I will delete this extra details from here. You can choose your edge line, X and delete your vertices. If you want, you can make it taller with extrusion. And give a shape with your vertices. For the blouse, I will choose all with A and after that E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. If you want, you can add solidify modifier here too. I will add some extra edge lines for the inner parts for giving flat shape. For adding extra details, we will use this again. Choose your faces, Shift D to duplicate, P selection. And Alt S to scale. And you can choose some part of it and you can make a bit taller it. Choose some faces again with Alt and Shift D to duplicate, P selection. Choose this detail and Alt S to scale. Tidy up your vertices how you want. If you want, you can give some water drop type shape, or you can add extra things. Select all E2X roots, right click and Alt S to scale. As the same method, we will add extra loop cuts for the giving sharp edge time. For the back, choose your faces and E2X root them up. You can move in X axis because mirror modifier's clipping is open. You can give a shape like that. Choose your faces and Alt S to scale for giving a bit volume. You can delete middle part of it. For this accessoire, you can E2X root, right click and Alt S to scale and add extra loop cuts in here. Choose two of extra detail and Ctrl J to join them together. Choose these faces, E2X root up and press X, delete your faces. Now you can choose your edge line and S in Y axis. Choose two edge lines, right click loop tool and bridge. For the bridge, you can go edit preferences, add-ons and type your loop tool. After that, you can use it with right click. Our blouse's detail will look like that. For the side, if you want, you can make it. E2X root, right click and Alt S to scale. Add extra loop cuts for the side for giving sharp edges. We will make same thing. For the amulets, you can choose some faces, shift it to duplicate, P selection. Choose all of it, Alt S to scale. If you want, you can E2X root in Z axis. For this necklace, you can make same thing, E2X root all faces. How you want, you can make it your detail. For the blouse detail, if you want, you can make some leaf parts. Choose some faces again, as the same method, Shift D, P selection, and give your vertices a shape. If you want, you can give a solidify to do. For the belt part, I will choose them and delete these faces. Press X and delete your faces. If you want to make a different belt shape, you can E2X root your edge lines and roll up around your character's belt and move your vertices for make suitable your character's body. I will make a bit of different accessoire for the belt. You can again as the same method, Shift D to duplicate, P selection and give a volume. And give a shape for this. For the back parts, you can tidy up it. Again, E2X root, right click and Alt S to scale. Give extra loop cuts. For the arm shield, you can choose your arm faces from your character's body in Tap to Edit mode. As the same method, Shift D to duplicate, P selection, choose all of them. In edit mode and E2X root. For giving top details, you can E2X root your edges. Add subdivision surface modifier and click cage. For the giving extra details, E2X root, right click and Alt S to scale. Add some loop cuts in here. Which shape you want, which type you want, you can make it. If you want, you can add some extra feathers, or you can make it a Viking type or Roman soldiers type. How you want, this is your model. For this arm shield, you can add mirror modifier and choose your mirror object as a character. From the ambitcg.com, I downloaded this metal material as a 2K and I will use it. From the 3D textures me, I downloaded this leather material and you can download it from this drive link. First, I will apply my mirror modifier for my blouse. And I will hide other parts with the edge. Let's add some material for our blouse. For the leather, go to Shading tab and press your Principal BSDF. Before this, go to Edit, preferences, add-ons, and type your node wrangler. We will use something in here. And press Ctrl-Shift-T, choose your ladder textures map. As you see, this is too big. We didn't like it. Press U and Smart UV Project, but still big pattern. Under the mapping node, you can change your scale. It can be glitchy some parts. We will make different things. Choose an edge line for yourself for the side part and right-click Mark Seam. For the inner part of your blouse, you can choose an edge line again and right-click Mark Seam. For the breast inner side, I will make same thing. Apply all transform, set origin to geometry. After in edit mode, choose all of it and you unwrap. As you see, these are stretched in here, but we will correct it. For this, under the blouse part, we will choose some edge line and mark seam in here and choose all of it with A, U and unwrap. As you see, our UV map in came in here and it will look good now. For the belt, I will make same material and this time I will U and Smart UV project. If it's not good for you, maybe it can be stretched sometimes, you can mark seam inner parts of your belt. And you unwrap this time. As you see, that's not stretching now. For the pants, I will use same material. I will U and Smart UV project it. If it's stretched in somewhere, as you see, you can add some mark seam and you can use this time unwrap. As you see, now it's look good for me. For the boots, I will use same thing. In this time, I will make Smart UV project for the unwrap. Let's add our gold material in here. In the shading tab, as the same method, Ctrl-Shift-T and choose your metal textures map. And you can use the Smart UV project for this too. And for the second material, you can press your plus icon in the materials tab and choose some faces. And for the leather material, choose this and assign. If your material is too light for you, you can add bright contrast node between the base color and principal BSDF and you can change your texture's color. As a second material, which face you want, you can choose these faces and assign your second material too. As you see, I'm adding my gold material again and assign. For the boots, I will choose some faces, especially some glitchy faces, and you can add your gold material in here. For the other parts, you can make same thing, assign your second material, which you want. For the other accessories, you can Alt-H to unhide them, and add your gold material in here. And you can link your materials together. For the amulets, I will add leather material in here too. With the plus icon, I'm adding my leather and assign. For the necklace part, I'm adding gold and leather material, which type you want. You can choose your faces and assign it. If you want to add extra things for your character's load, you can go from the top right card. I showed before how to make some different vector meshes to the 3D mesh. You can use this method. Or if you want, you can use some stencil paint method. As I said before, from the top right card, you can find all the videos from there. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.